Move over iPod. The frenzy over the iPhone has hit America. In just about 50 minutes, the newest revolutionary phone device goes on sale at select stores.
The must-have, got to have it, do you really need it sort of deal? When the clock struck 6 o'clock on the East Coast, people who have been waiting for days started flooding into the stores. Among those in line, the mayor of Philadelphia, and that didn't sit well with one voter.
I just don't think any taxpayer looking into this is going to be very happy about this. We're sitting and we're thinking, okay, we're not able to do all this stuff at a city, at any kind of a job, and come out here and just wait for a phone?
Right, but I get called around all the time. I mean, I have to be able to be anywhere, and I can do my job. Fortunately, I can do my job wherever I am.
Oh, yeah.
Closer to home, out at Arden Fair Mall, there's a line as well. We're told maybe 166 people, something like that. Is that what I understand? Is that what it looks like?
Yeah, David Bienick is covering all the frenzy out there at Arden Fair Mall. Here's the story.
People started lining up at 9 o'clock last night outside the Apple store in Arden Fair Mall. And by noon today, there were 60 future customers all eagerly waiting, along with some of the technological devices they hope the iPhone will replace.
I'm kind of tired of having that Batman utility belt with my iPod, my cell phone. I'm just ready to combine everything into one and, you know, have a new toy.
A $500 toy, which Apple promises will do the job of a cell phone, a music and video player, and a wireless internet browser. Apple, which is based in the Bay Area and also has a facility in Elk Grove, is counting on the iPhone to be its next big money maker.
There's still so much secrecy surrounding it that a lot of the news is just finally getting out. So I don't even know everything about it, and, you know, I'm sitting here waiting in line for 20 hours.
Similar to when Apple launched its Macintosh computer back in 1984 with this now famous commercial.
Computer will introduce Macintosh.
UC Davis professor of techno-cultural studies Jesse Drew says interest in the iPhone is the result of marketing hype, but also a true technological advance.
I think it is something that people have been wanting to do, wanting to have for quite a while.
Professor Drew says the iPhone will not change our lives as much as, for example, the VCR, which came out in the 1980s, transistor radio, which came out in the 1960s, or television, which came out in the 1950s. And while some analysts predict that over the next 2 years as many as 45 million iPhones will be sold, many people were ready to pass by the line at the store today and wait to see if this truly is the next big thing.
I'm not one of those people that rushes out and buys things right off the bat. I kind of wait and see how things go.
So who are the people waiting in line today? Well, we surveyed the first 30 customers in line, and here's what we found out. 77% are men, 23% are women, the average age 24.1 years old.
Early adopters, I think they're called, Lois, and the average amount of time they spend attached to some sort of electronic gizmo each day, get this, 12 hours. Wow. More details on what iPhone buyers do for a living and they like to eat is online at KCRA.com. We're going to be there live when they open up the Apple Store at 6 o'clock tonight. You got to see this.
And they better have their $600, right?
Yeah,
is that what they cost?
$600
wow.
for that thing, yeah.